What if I told you the key to our stable climate lies deep in the ocean, and it's in trouble? Let's see what the fuzz is all about in today's video. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into a topic that's as critical as it is fascinating. The Earth's largest heat transfer system and the alarming possibility of its shutdown. This system, driven by ocean currents, is extremely fundamental in regulating global temperatures and weather patterns. But here's the thing, we might be looking at an impending collapse of this system, and the consequences could be catastrophic for every single one of us. In this video, we'll explore the science behind this system, the signs of its potential demise, and what it could mean for our planet's future. So, if you're ready to learn about what could potentially be one of the most important catastrophes of our time, keep watching. First things first, let's dive into what the Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or Amoc, actually is. Picture the ocean as a giant conveyor belt, constantly moving water around the globe. This conveyor belt, known as the Amoc, transports warm, salty water from the tropics northward along the surface to the North Atlantic. As this warm water reaches colder northern latitudes, it cools down and becomes denser, causing it to sink deep into the ocean. The cold, dense water then flows back southward in the ocean depths, eventually upwelling and warming again in the tropics to complete the cycle. This continuous loop of warm surface flow and cold, deep return flow is crucial for regulating Earth's climate and weather patterns by redistributing heat around the planet. In fact, the Amoc moves heat at an astounding rate of 1 petawatt, which is about 50 times the energy use of all humankind. Think of the Amoc as Earth's natural thermostat, working tirelessly to keep our climate in balance. Turning this system off can significantly alter what our planet is going to look like. Take Europe, for example. It benefits greatly from the warm water transported by the Amoc, which keeps its climate milder than other regions at similar latitudes. In fact, the Amoc moves heat at an astounding rate of 1 petawatt, which is about 50 times the energy use of all humankind. But here's the kicker. Should there be any change to this delicate system, it would signal huge implications for our planet. As greenhouse gases trap more heat in the atmosphere, the oceans absorb this excess warmth, altering circulation patterns that transport heat around the globe. Even small shifts in these currents can have a large effect on global climate. So while the Amoc has been regulating Earth's temperature for millennia, the unprecedented rate of change since the mid-20th century is putting this vital system at risk. And if it were to shut down completely, the consequences could be like none we've ever seen before. If this vital system either slows or shut down, it could lead to some pretty dramatic changes across the globe. We're talking about more extreme weather events, rising sea levels, and shifts in tropical monsoon patterns that millions rely on for agriculture. A weakening Amoc could cause abrupt cooling across large parts of the Northern Hemisphere, with Europe potentially seeing much colder winters and hotter summers. It would also accelerate sea level rise around North America, with some studies suggesting up to a meter of additional rise in the North Atlantic under an Amoc collapse. But the impacts wouldn't stop there. A shutdown of this kind of regulating system could alter rainfall patterns around the equator, endangering the Amazon rainforest and Antarctic ice sheets. It might even cause California to suddenly switch between cycles of extreme drought and deluge. Essentially, a failing Amoc could flip our climate as we know it on its head. While a complete collapse remains uncertain, the unprecedented rate of change since the mid-20th century is putting this critical system at risk. As our climate continues to warm, closely monitoring the Amoc will be crucial for understanding and mitigating the potential catastrophic consequences of its decline. It's not just about temperature we would have to worry about. The changes in ocean currents can also dramatically affect rainfall patterns worldwide. A weakening Amoc could cause the tropical rain belt to shift southward, potentially leading to more droughts in regions like the Sahel and Amazon, while increasing flooding in others like the southern US. These changes in precipitation could have far-reaching consequences for agriculture, water resources, and natural ecosystems. For example, a drier Amazon rainforest would absorb less carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, further amplifying global warming. Moreover, the Amoc helps store vast amounts of heat and carbon in the deep ocean. If it were to shut down, this stored heat and carbon could be released back into the atmosphere, accelerating the rate of climate change even further. So while the Amoc might seem like a distant, abstract concept, its influence on our daily lives and the future of our planet cannot be overstated. As we continue to grapple with the challenges of a changing climate, understanding and protecting this critical system will be more important than ever. In short, the Amoc is like that underrated maintenance guy making sure our climate system runs smoothly, working behind the scenes to keep things stable. If it were to fail, the effects would be felt all over the world, impacting a wide radius from agriculture to economies and even our daily lives. Scientists have been keeping a close eye on the Amoc, and they've found some early warning signals that suggest its weakening. One of the key methods they use is analyzing sea surface temperatures and salinity levels in the North Atlantic. Over the past 150 years, data has shown fluctuations that hint at a potential destabilization of this crucial system. Recent studies have detected a significant slowdown in the Amoc, and some models predict that it could collapse as early as 2025, with the likeliest point of collapse between 2039 and 2070. These early warning signals are like the canary in the coal mine, alerting us to the fact that something major could be happening beneath the ocean surface. But what does that mean for us? What do you guys think? Is it something worth worrying about? Let us know by leaving a comment below. Who knows? It might be your solution that can be the key to the salvation of the Amoc. Back to the topic. These signals indicate that the tipping point might be closer than we think. For this reason, paying attention to these early warning signs is crucial for understanding and preparing for what might come next. So what's causing this potential collapse? The primary culprit is global warming. As the planet heats up due to greenhouse gas emissions, several key factors come into play that disrupt the Amoc. First, warmer temperatures cause the surface waters in the North Atlantic to heat up. Warm water is less dense than cold water, which means it doesn't sink as readily. This is a problem because the sinking of cold, dense water in the North Atlantic is a crucial part of the Amoc's conveyor belt mechanism. Second, the melting of polar ice caps, particularly in Greenland, adds a significant amount of fresh water to the ocean. Fresh water is less salty and therefore less dense than seawater. This influx of fresh water further reduces the density of surface waters, making it even harder for them to sink and continue to the deep ocean circulation. Together, these factors weaken the Amoc by disrupting the delicate balance of temperature and salinity that drives its circulation. Essentially, global warming is throwing a wrench into the works of this massive oceanic conveyor belt, potentially leading to its slowdown or collapse. This is a stark reminder of how interconnected our planet's systems are and how human activities can have far-reaching impacts. It's not just theoretical models and predictions. We've already observed a tangible slowdown in the Amoc. Since the mid-20th century, studies indicate that the Amoc has weakened by about 15%. This isn't just a small blip. It's a significant change that has researchers deeply concerned. So what can we do about it? Addressing the potential collapse of the Amoc requires a multifaceted approach, with a primary focus on mitigating climate change. Here are some key actions we can take. First, we can put great effort into reducing greenhouse gas emissions. This is the most critical step. By transitioning to renewable energy sources like solar, wind, and hydroelectric power, we can drastically cut down on the emissions that contribute to global warming. This includes efforts at both the individual level, such as using energy-efficient appliances and reducing car travel, and at the policy level, like implementing carbon taxes and investing in green technologies. Second, we have to protect and restore forests. Forests act as carbon sinks, absorbing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Protecting existing forests and reforesting degraded areas can help offset some of the emissions and slow the rate of global warming. Next up is promoting sustainable agriculture. Agricultural practices can significantly impact greenhouse gas emissions. By adopting sustainable farming techniques such as crop rotation, reduced tillage, and organic farming, we can reduce the carbon footprint of food production. Following that, we also have to improve energy efficiency. Enhancing the energy efficiency of buildings, transportation, and industrial processes can reduce overall energy consumption and emissions. This includes better insulation, energy-efficient lighting, and the adoption of electric vehicles. Another thing we can do is to raise awareness and launch educational campaigns. Public awareness and education are crucial. By informing people about the importance of the Amoc and the broader impacts of climate change, we can foster a culture of environmental stewardship and encourage collective action. We also will need to support climate research. Continued investment in climate research is essential for improving our understanding of the Amoc and developing more accurate predictive models. This research can inform policy decisions and help us prepare for potential future scenarios. By taking these steps, we can work towards slowing the progression of global warming and in turn help stabilize the Amoc. It's a complex challenge, but with concerted global effort and cooperation, we can make a significant impact. Remember, every action counts, no matter how small it may seem. Now, let's talk about the future. While the situation with the Amoc is concerning, it's not all doom and gloom. Scientists and policymakers around the world are working hard to understand and address these changes. International cooperation is key here. International cooperation is key to all problems. Climate change is a global issue, and it requires a global response. One promising area of research is geoengineering, which involves large-scale interventions to counteract climate change. For instance, some scientists are exploring ways to artificially enhance the reflectivity of clouds, or even remove carbon dioxide directly from the atmosphere. While these ideas are still in the experimental stage, they represent the kind of innovative thinking that could help mitigate the impacts of a weakening Amoc. Additionally, there are efforts to improve climate models and early warning systems. By better understanding the complex interactions within our climate system, we can develop more accurate predictions and prepare more effectively for potential changes. This includes everything from improving infrastructure to withstand extreme weather events, to developing new agricultural practices that can cope with changing rainfall patterns. Another step we can take is calling out the corporations producing massive amounts of waste that damage the atmosphere and the mechanisms of the global ecosystems to take action now. The nation's governments are accountable and responsible too. Join mass action and encourage the lawmakers to make legislation that support the protection of the environment. Ultimately, the future of the Amoc and our climate depends on the actions we take today. By reducing greenhouse gas emissions, investing in renewable energy, supporting scientific research, and supporting activism, we can work towards a more stable and sustainable future. It's a challenging road ahead, but with collective effort and determination, we can make a difference. It's a great way to wrap up the discussion with a call to action, isn't it? The potential collapse of the Amoc is a stark reminder of the urgent need to address climate change. This is not an impending issue. The term climate crisis tells us the problem is already here. We're not preparing for a house fire. The house is already burning, and the task now is to be creative in putting out the fire. Remember, the future of our planet depends on the actions we take today. By working together, we can help ensure a stable and healthy environment for generations to come. Before we wrap it up, thank you so much for watching today's video. I really hope you like it. If you did, why don't you leave us a like to let us know the types of videos that you enjoy? Or if you think this sucks, go ahead and hit that dislike. I won't feel bad, I promise. Or if you have other things you want to say, leave us a comment too. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and as always, stay insanely curious.